Okay, I thought I'd do a quick little video today about how to set a toilet. In a previous video, which you want to look up, I showed you where to set the flange of the toilet. And I've just completed doing this bathroom, so this tile now that I just put down has changed from the height from the original. And now it's just about flush, so the flange here is just about flush with the tile. And that's not good. What you want is... it's as if you put this flange on top of the tile, okay? So we can't really change that now because this is already set. So what I'm going to do is use a spacer, which you can purchase. This one's made by Odie. And there's two different ways you can put the spacer, actually. One is like this, so that the toilet bolts go in like that. Or you can set them so the toilet bolts go in like this. Now, I'm going to use that method only because these don't line up with the old one very well. Now, you may notice this particular flange is kind of crooked. It's lower here than it is here, and that's okay. The wax ring will make up for it. And this is already screwed down, so I don't have to worry about that. The screws are already there. I've already cleaned the wax off to as much as I can. So I'm going to set this spacer on top now, and I'm going to set the toilet screws, the bolts in here first, and then I'm going to screw this down, okay? And when I do the wax ring, I always use this style, which has this little funnel attached to the wax. So that funnels the water into the pipe and really avoids any kind of leaks. So I'm going to use that style. So first what I want to do here is get some silicone. This is just clear silicone. And I'm going to put this all through the edge. I want to make sure that there's nothing that can leak through there. And as I said, this flange is already screwed down. So this I am going to screw down as well, but it's really not holding much. So I'm going to put these in first. Find my other one here. Here it is. So those bolts are actually going to be held by the flange below. But I need to put them in first here just so that they line up correctly. All right. And then I'm just going to take a screw gun here and screw this down. So these screws aren't really holding anything, but I just want to tie the two flanges, or I should say the flange and the spacer, together. So now we have these, and they provide you, found one of them, here's the other one. They provide you with these little plastic rings here, which will you can put on now, and that'll keep the bolt upright. So I put those on now. So when I actually set the toilet, these will help keep the bolts where they're supposed to be. All right, so that's that. Next step is I gotta go get the toilet, bring that up here, and sometimes I'll do a test fit if I'm worried about, you know, spacing or whatever, but I think we're pretty good here, so I'm gonna go get that now and then I'll start the video again. Okay, I have the toilet up here now, and you can see I put it on a piece of cardboard just so I don't scratch the floor up. And, you know, there's two ways you can put the wax ring on. One is to put it on the base of the toilet where it goes, or you could put it on the flange first. I usually work alone, so for me, I just find it easier to put it on the flange first, and that way I don't have it ever just dropping off the toilet as I'm trying to put the toilet on. So that's what I do, but there's no right or wrong way. It's just really personal preference. And I don't know if I could show you this. I'm not sure this will get on video, but I gotta be careful here, but the bottom of the toilet, is that even on? I can just get that on camera. You know, the wax ring would go here if you decided to go that route. Let me see if I could do that. If I can hold that, you would put that on like that, kind of smush it there a little bit. But like I said, I just prefer to use the wax ring on the flange first. So I'm going to do that now. And this is always sticky and gooey. Try not to leave this out in the heat. That just melts way too fast. Alright, so let's going to drop that in there like that. Put this aside. You don't want to get the wax everywhere. And then I just make sure this is centered in the hole there. Now, these bolts are still sticking up. Sometimes they get in the wax a little bit. That's fine. And then, let me see if I can do this in one fell swoop here. I'm going to get the toilet. And I need to line up the bolt holes with the bolts, and I'm not sure this will even get on camera, but I'll give it a try. So I look at one side before I drop it down. I can see the bolt coming in. On that side, oh, I lost my bolt on the other side. All right, I've lined them up, and then when I'm sure I'm lined up correctly, then I'll drop it down and slowly smush the wax in there. Now, before I take it all the way, I want to get my level, because you want to get this thing level if you can, or as close to it as you can. And that's not looking great, actually. I prefer this side to come up a little bit. Now, before I really smush this down, you want to try to get as level as you can, and you don't want this thing to rock. So there are plastic shims you can get. This is an example of one. They actually make some smaller ones designed for toilets, but I'm going to get these shims, and I'm not sure I can even do this on camera, but basically I'm going to shim underneath here in a few different places until I get it where I want it, and then I'll bolt down with the nuts they provide the toilet base, and then after that we got some more things to do. So let me just do some shimming here, and then I'll get you back on camera. I got some shims in here, and now I've got it side to side pretty good. As good as I'm going to get. The front to back is not as good, but there's not a lot I can do about it given this floor here. The whole floor is pretty bad, so I'm going to take that. And you can't just leave these shims like this, obviously, so I'm going to take a utility knife, just score them here, and then snap them off. And that's going to leave pieces of shim in these places. At that point, I'm going to bolt it down, but you can't just leave those shims there and expect them to stay. So there's two ways you're going to kind of cement those shims in place, and this is part of the next task anyway, which is either to caulk this whole edge here, and I like to use a color matched caulk that matches the grout. Okay, so if you can get that, that's great. Or in some cases when I've used quite a lot of shims and there's quite a bit of space here, I don't want to rely on caulk to hold everything in place, so I'll actually take some of the grout, assuming it's a sanded grout, and I'll install that along that edge here. Now, I'm not going to kill it, I'm not going to cement this thing in permanently, but just enough grout in there to hold everything in place. That'll hold the shims in place, it'll help provide a little more support under that gap, and that will also help seal the base of the toilet, which is something you need to do. There's also another instance where I'll use grout is when the floor is kind of wavy, in which case there might be gaps here, and I don't like that. I don't want to rely on caulk for that. So again, I'll use the sanded grout for that. And actually, sometimes if I notice the homeowner, quite honestly, is very heavy or a big guy or something like that, and there's going to be a lot of weight on this, I just don't want this thing rocking in the future. So again, I'll use the grout. So either way is acceptable. The grout, you don't want to just smear it on there. I mean, you want to make a nice clean line and not make it so much so that you can never remove this toilet, because that's a problem. But if you're careful about it, don't kill it, it will come off. I've taken them off myself. But other than that, try to use the color match caulk. And again, be careful. I see so many homeowners where the caulk is just smeared everywhere. You don't want to see that. Make a nice neat line. Smear it in with your finger, wipe off any excess with a paper towel, and then make sure it's neat, nice and neat looking. Alright, so let me clip off these shims, and then I'll show you the next steps. Okay, the next step is to bolt this thing down, and I got two sides worth here. So basically you have, don't forget this because it's easy to do, you know, there's a plastic, like a snap washer basically, and it does go a certain way. It says right on it, this side up. Okay, so that, here's the porcelain on the toilet. This goes on next. All right, and then a metal washer, and then the nut, which we'll put on. And what we're going to do is tighten this nut down. After the nut is tightened, we'll put on this cap, and that cap snaps onto this little plastic washer that we put down first. So we get that side going, and I'm going to use an actual wrench rather than an adjustable wrench because I think it's easier to get a precise adjustment. All right, and let me get the other side going here. All right, as we start to get tighter here, you're going to slow down a little bit. You just want to get this snug. You don't have to be the Incredible Hulk, because you will crack this bowl if you, and especially if you have shims here. So just, you know, until it starts to feel a little bit snug, all right? You don't have to crank it. You don't have to use all your arms to do this. And I do a little bit on each side, all right? And that's about snug. Now, what I usually do now is, this cap goes on next, and obviously it can't because this bolt is in the way, so you need to saw it off. You can use a power tool, but just to show you that you can use a hand tool, what I usually do is, I don't know if I can get in here with the camera, I'm trying to leave some space, I put the wrench on the nut just to keep it from moving and turning, and I come down in here low. Once you get partway through, you can just bend it right off, okay? And now I'll do the same thing on the other side, but then since I kind of play with that a little bit, I just give it a little quarter turn, and that's it. All right, so I'll do the same thing on the other side, and then this cap now has room to snap on, all right? Now, I'll do the same thing on the other side in a second, but let me show you one other thing. If I can move the camera here. I have not, if you have a one-piece toilet, you're almost done. But I have a two-piece toilet here, and that's probably more common. And the top of these toilets go on all different ways. So you're really going to have, there's no way for me to tell you in advance what to look for, but they're all going to be different. So follow the manufacturer's instructions. But again, you don't want to torque this thing down like the Incredible Hulk. Just get things snug. When you're putting the tank on, make sure you get the tank level or start level. And then when you're tightening, it's usually either two or sometimes three bolts. And when you're tightening them up, make sure you tighten them evenly so that the tank, when it's settled and it's done, is level. That's especially important. And the rubber gasket that goes here, again, when you're putting the top on, make sure it's seated correctly. Just spend a little extra time, a minute, just to take a look in here and make sure everything is starting correctly and it'll end correctly too. And then, so I can get in here. As far as connecting the water, again, the top's got to be on first. The old school method was to use solid tubing, which is fine if you want to go through that effort. I use stainless braided stainless steel is what I'm trying to say, hoses, which last an extremely long time. It's not been any problem at all. So I usually use those, and I think they're actually superior in some ways because they allow a little bit of flex if the toilet gets bumped or whatever. So that's where we are now. So let me just finish the other side, and then I'm going to show you, in this case, I am going to grout the base, so I'll show you what that looks like. Okay, I've mixed up a little bit of the grout that I used on the tile in a cup here, and I'm just using a wooden shim. It doesn't really matter what you use. And just like when I grout, I'm going to smush it in there. But again, I'm not going to put so much in there that I can't ever get this toilet off. Just enough to cover the edge. I'm not going to force it. I'm not going to sit there and force it in for hours on end. I just want to cover that gap and give it a little extra support at the same time. And as long as you don't put too much on there, you'll be able to get this toilet back off and scrape off this grout if you ever have to put a different toilet on with a different shape to the base. Alright, so I'll just do that, and then just like when I grout, I got my clean water and my grouting sponge, and I'll wipe that down nice and clean. And this will help hold those shims in place, as well as provide a little extra support. All right, here's a little bonus footage for this particular toilet, which is a Kohler. I gotta be careful here, I don't break something, but basically I want you to look at the base here, or at the top I should say, and I'm in trouble doing this and showing on camera. There we go. In this case, the way this goes together is, I don't really care for it actually. There's a rubber gasket here, which is normal, and then these rubber gaskets here on these three bolts are on this side and also on the other side, and you're just going to bolt this down. But as I was saying before, you want to make sure that this rubber seats correctly and the whole top is level in the hole right here. So let's see if I can do that on camera here. So we're just going to carefully insert this. So that's basically lined up. But there is a little wiggle room there, which is why I usually get my level out and make sure I start as level as I can, or at least plausibly level, all right? So that's about right there. And then I'll start bolting this down. And again, don't torque the hell out of this thing, just get it snug. And as I'm snugging up these nuts, which I'm not sure I can show you on camera here, but as I'm snugging these up, I make sure that I keep an eye on this level so I keep the tank from, you know, going one way or the other. All right, I've got the tank attached now. It's solid, ready to go. And I'm not quite ready to attach the water line yet because I have some other work to do and that would be in my way. But I don't want to leave this toilet open without any anything to trap the sewer gases in there. And of course, there is a trap built into every toilet, but you need water to seal it. So if you're just going to leave this for a period of time, plus if you want to test it, just get a bucket of water. That's enough to get a flush. And there'll be a little bit of water left in there, and that'll help trap any sewer gases from getting into the house. And if you don't have any leaks on the bottom here, and you don't hear anyone screaming from down below, then you're probably in good shape.